Gentlemen, today we got Matt here. He's gonna tell you a thing or two about the new Joker movie. Take it away, Matt.
Thanks, Tobias, for that wonderful introduction. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about what my thoughts were about the Joker. I kind of have a differing opinion. Not so much as like I disliked the movie fully, more that I had specific problems with it. I guess the first thing that I kind of want to talk about is just sort of kind of a lack of focus for me personally. It seemed that it jumped from idea to different idea without ever fully encompassing things for me. Because I thought it started off, and I thought it was gonna, I was trying not to do spoilers either. So, I thought it was gonna be more about like mental illness and society's impact on that, but then it kind of changed into like classism and that sort of thing. And then it kind of, in the third act, was more just kind of based on maybe media and society, which are all really good points. It's just that I don't think it ever got resolved fully in there. I think the director Todd Phillips had something to say, but never really told us what, like the point fully to me. Now, I understand that movies can be subjective and that too, but I like to understand like the director's point of view. It's a director's movie, so I like understanding what your stance is on things. I think the movie is gorgeous. The aesthetic is beautiful. Very reminiscent of Taxi Driver, King of Comedies, those old 70s Martin Scorsese crime dramas, and fantastic job there. I think it may have borrowed a little too much from it, almost to the point of copying, because the script itself is almost pretty much Taxi Driver from beginning to end, almost, for me. There was the character itself. I think Joaquin Phoenix is a good actor. Absolutely. There's no doubt about it. Wonderful actor. I think that the problem I had was that he started at a 10 and ended at a 10 for me. Like, he was crazy off the beginning and just didn't grow to the point of, like, okay, yeah, you want to, like, in a narrative, in a narrative hook, you got your character, and if you want like a descent into madness sort of narrative, you start here, and then you end up going to the crazy. So like your Shinings, your other ones that I can't think of right now, but it's like
Clockwork Orange.
Clockwork Orange. I mean, you have your character who starts fairly normally, right? Maybe a few ticks here and there, and then as the movie goes on, it just spirals downward. Whereas I felt you already started down here, and you kind of just stayed there. There's just many moments to me that just felt like craziness for craziness' sake, instead of having like a point to it, more of like, look at how crazy I am. Like, let me, like, there's seven different times where the Joker will do his weird dancing, which is fine, which is good, and I think Joaquin Phoenix does a good job. I'm not trying to shit on him at all. I think he did well. It's just there's no, you know, there's no driving up for me. Like when you start a movie and it's just like this, you know, and, like, you're crying. Like, that's, you're like, okay, he's already fucking crazy at this point. I got, like, you know. But, like, let's start fairly normally. And then by the end of that movie, you're just like, whoa, he's completely lost it. Instead of, oh, he's lost it. And, yeah, he's still gone. He's gone. It's still gone. You know? So that's just another issue I had with it. I think there's a lot of glitz and a lot of, like, very surface level things to it. But I like making a metaphor of, like, if you bought $1,000 kernel of popcorn, that the kernel of popcorn probably looks really, really good. And it probably tastes good initially. But when you swallow it and eat it, you don't get dinner from that, right? So that's kind of what the feeling I had, was that it looks really, really good. And, like, it's acted well and stuff, but when I want to talk about it, I'll be like, okay, so what is the point? Where's your point? Is your point that the Joker is a good focal point for resistance against the 1%? Is the Joker your societal, like, mental illness in society just kind of giving up on that? And by society giving up on him, does that create the monster? But at the end, the monster is almost shown as the hero. There's just a lot of different conflicting thoughts, and I kind of wanted a more, like, specific point. Gosh, what else did I say about it? But I think mostly what I wanted to say is that when you create the Joker, and I think this movie works a lot better if the Joker title is not attached to it. I think it's stronger if it's not attached to it, because the Joker has very certain connotations to it. Like, the Joker's been a character in pop culture for God knows how long.
Since the early 50s.
Since the early 50s, right? So, and there's been so many different variations and stuff like that. So when an audience member goes in and says, okay, you're going to be watching a Joker movie, I have certain expectations. This guy has certain expectations. This guy has certain expectations. And from what I know of the Joker, and I'm not a huge Batman, like, expert or anything like that, but from what I know about the Joker is that not only is he psychotic, is that he's intelligent, like, supremely intelligent. And I didn't get that in this movie. Do I think that Joaquin Phoenix's Joker is smart? No. Do I think he would outsmart Batman? No, I don't think he would, personally. Because he doesn't do anything very intelligent throughout. And I mean, I guess you can grow to that point since it's more of an origin story. But you have a bunch of different what I want from this movie. Whereas if you just said, hey, this is a movie called Arthur, and here's this person who's lost in life.
There you go.
What was I saying? I think the movie would work a lot better if it was just Arthur, and kind of based off that character with, like, the Joker removed from it, because it's more based on, like, one man's rejection from society and his kind of own internal redemption. Whereas when you bring in the Joker, you have such different connotations to that character. With everybody else, I think, did a really good job. Robert De Niro was an odd choice for that, but I think that was more based on his performance in other, like, those Taxi Driver type-esque movies. I mean, he's Taxi Driver.
Noir crime noir.
So, yeah. film noir, crime noir. I don't want to like just say bad things. There's some things that I did really like. The aesthetic I talked about, there was really clever choices with the character, I think, that paid off. His laughing symptom syndrome thing, I thought was super well done, and it added to that story, and it led to certain like plot points, which I really liked. Whenever he's interacting with another person, I think is really, really good, and I wish they just had a lot more of that too, because then you get that dichotomy of like how really crazy he is compared to everybody else, whereas like 90% of the movie is just him doing stuff by himself, and it gets almost to the point of there's a word I want to say and I can't think of it. Sensitized. You get desensitized to his craziness a bit, because it's just so constant and so much in your face. Whereas when I love when he's interacting with other people, because you really, really, really get to pick that up. And so anytime he's interacting with other characters in the movie, I really liked. I just wish there was more than that, more of that. So I also want to like shout out to WB having like a wide release of a movie that's risky and has controversial elements. I think the controversy around the Joker itself, the movie, and that it promotes violence is stupid, because movies have been promoting violence to society since the beginning. It's just another scare tactic, I think. But overall, I would probably give it 3 out of 5. Fairly good. I think it's on the cusp of being something great, and it has the foundation to be something great. It's just that there was never anything built on the foundation for me. But that is my thoughts of the Joker. Whether or not you liked it or not, I hope you talked about it and had, you know, thoughts and feelings, because that's what movies are about. So if you did that, then a movie does its job. So thanks for listening. Tobias, take it away.
And that, there you go. His thoughts on the Joker. Thank you, Matt.
Thank you.
We'll see you guys later. Bye.
Watch Wonder Bread.